This is Laura GB, and this is day 12 of the 12 days of paginated reports. And in this video, we're going to look at replacing custom SQL with a procedure. Here we are in our report, and this is the report from the day 7 video in this series. And we have a couple of data sets, and if we go and have a look at the deliveries data set, which is used for this table, do a right click and dataset properties. In there, there is an SQL statement that's been edited. We edited it to include the or type equals all. And if I click on Query Designer, because it's been edited, you can no longer use the visual designer. You've got to now use text. So we've got to keep track of the SQL, etc. Well, that makes this report harder to maintain, and this kind of thing should go back into the database if possible. So be nice to your DBA, buy them cookies or whatever it requires, and get them to write a procedure for you. So that's what we're going to look at, replacing that data set. So we're going to go for a brand new data set and then look at replacing the data set in the table. So right click on data sets and add a data set. And I'm going to call this new deliveries, and let's give it the same data source as the old one. And query type, I'm going to click on stored procedure. And then it asks you, well, what procedure do you want? And there's one that's already been written. So get day gifts with costs. And then we're going to go to, and I happen to know that needs a parameter. So we then go to parameters, and there you are. It needs a parameter called gift type. Well, we've already got a parameter set up. So I can do a drop down here and I could click type. And then we're going to click OK. And there you are, we've got a second data set on the left there with the same columns as the deliveries one. Okay, so we set up the procedure to be returned exactly the same data columns. And because we did that, and we made sure the columns are all called the same things, etc. If I now go to click on the table, select it, over on the right-hand side, in the general section, it picks which data set it's related to. So there we are. I'm going to drop down that arrow, and I'm going to go for new deliveries. Delete the old one, so we know that actually there's nothing clever going on behind the scenes. Delete that one. And let's run our report. Now, there are times that the first time you load up the report like this, it appears to not have all the data. But if I go to print layout, there we are. We've got our data. And we can pick our filter and view our report. And there we are. It gets filtered. And we can save it back to the Power BI service. And we can switch across and open up our report and confirm. That it still works. So in this video, we took a look at using a procedure to replace some custom SQL. I hope you've enjoyed the 12 days of paginated reports. There will be more paginated reports coming. So if you haven't, please press subscribe. Take care now.